Today we are targeting the civil service examination questions. Normally, if you examine the latest question papers, you get nearly 45 to 50 questions from three subjects. Of course, related to current affairs also. First is economy, in which you get around 15 to 18 questions. Then comes history, you get around 18 questions. Then Indian polity, you get around 15 to 16 questions. The total is nearly 45 to 50 questions, which means you get 100 marks out of 200. The cutoff for civil service prelim exam is nearly 116 to 120. That would be the maximum. So you are sure to get through the preliminary examination if you are thorough with the economy, Indian polity, and history. In addition to this, you should study economic survey, budget, and all schemes of Government of India for the past 18 months, and all bills which have been passed by both the Houses of Parliament and have become Act. These four items will give you around 8 to 10 questions from the current affairs. One of the most important topic which was explained in the economic survey is the monetary policy transmission. What is monetary policy transmission? That is, whatever the changes made by the RBI in the repo rates have not percolated to the customers. That is, the lending rate remained constant, though the RBI has reduced the repo rate and reverse repo rate. As far as lending rates are concerned, as you know, before 1990, our country was a closed economy. That is, the interest rates were regulated by the RBI. The government used to fix the interest rate. Accordingly, the lending rate also used to be fixed. So the government intervention was there. Subsequently, after economic reforms, that is after 1990, RBI deregulated the lending rates. Of course, for the loans, about 2 lakh. This was done in October 1994. Banks were given the freedom to fix the lending rate according to their commercial judgment. So states do not interfere. Subsequently, the banks were asked to declare what is known as prime lending rate. Remember, this is the interest rate which the bank should charge to the most creditworthy customers. However, this system also lacked transparency. Therefore, the RBI introduced what is popularly known as benchmark prime lending rate in April 2003. The purpose was to make the system more transparent. Then, of course, the RBI again found that the banks were misusing the benchmark prime lending rate by lending money at a rate lower than the benchmark rate to some privileged customers at the cost of the normal poor customers. That is, the retail customers were charged more interest while the privileged customers were charged less interest. This is known as cross-subsidization. In addition, this system was also not transparent. When the interest rate was down, only the new customers were given the lower rate and the old customers continued to pay the higher rate of interest. This was the position. To rectify this situation, the base rate system was introduced by RBI in July 2010. Remember, under this system, the banks have to announce their base rate, which should be the minimum rate under all circumstances. This system had also certain defects like lack of transparency and lack of accountability and lack of percolation of the revision and the repo rates to the customers. The RBI expected that as and when there is a change in the repo rate, it will percolate to the customers. This did not happen in the case of base rate also. Accordingly, the RBI again introduced what is known as marginal cost of funds based lending rate system for the new loans from 1st April 2016. Under this system, the marginal cost of funds negative carry on CRR, operating cost and tenor premium have been taken into account. Remember, banks get their funds not only from RBI, they get the funds from the deposit and interbank transactions, etc. So RBI's argument that they are reducing the repo rate and accordingly the interest rate should be reduced is not valid, because it is not the RBI funds alone is being given to the borrowers. In addition to this, remember, the CRR, the cash reserve ratio, say 4% of the NDTL, which is kept with the RBI, do not carry any interest. In addition, SLR, in SLR only the government security carry interest, neither the gold nor the cash kept in as a part of SLR. So these arguments were put forth by the banks to the RBI. But the fact remained that as and when the repo rate or reverse repo rate was reduced, that did not percolate to the customers. Accordingly, now the RBI has introduced the external benchmark system. External benchmark system. Under the external benchmark system, the banks are free to take any of the following. Number one, they can take the RBI policy rate or the treasury bills yield for 3 months or the treasury bills yield for 6 months or the rates fixed by the Financial Benchmark India Private Limited. So whatever benchmark fixed by this organization, the commercial banks can adopt. In addition to this, the banks are free to add certain percentage as that for instance for towards the margin and towards the risk premium, they are free to add certain percentage in addition to the repo rate. This is the present situation of what is known as external benchmark system. In nutshell, earlier there was no such system. Subsequently, prime lending rate was introduced, which was modified as benchmark prime lending rate, which was again changed to base rate. Subsequently, it was changed to marginal cost of funds based lending rate, and now it stands external benchmark system.